Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 4.1, Problem 3. This is Section 4.1, Problem 3. It says, write the initial simplex tableau for the problem shown below, and we have maximize z equals 8x1 plus 5x2 plus 3x3 plus 2x4, subject to 2x1 plus 3x2 plus 5x3 plus x4 is less than or equal to 1,200. 3x, and after that, 3x1 plus 2x2 plus 6x3 plus x4 is less than or equal to 860. And then x1 is greater than or equal to 0, x2 is greater than or equal to 0, x3 is greater than or equal to 0, and x4 is greater than or equal to 0. So what we have to do is change this problem into a matrix, and we do that by changing our constraints from being linear inequalities into linear equations, because a matrix really is a group of linear equations, not a group of linear inequalities. So I'll start with the first constraint, 2x1 plus 3x2 plus 5x3 plus x4 is less than or equal to 1,200. And I'm going to write the equation 2x1 plus 3x2 plus 5x3 plus x4 plus s1 plus, and then I'm going to leave a little bit of a space. I don't need the plus for that. I'm going to leave a little bit of a space equals 1,200. So now the first constraint was changed from a linear inequality to a linear equation by adding a slack variable. So now the next constraint, which is the linear inequality, 3x1 plus 2x2 plus 6x3 plus x4 is less than or equal to 860, will also be turned into a linear equation. So to do that, I will write 3x1 plus 2x2 plus 6x3 plus x4 plus, I'm going to leave a little bit of a space, s2, a different slack variable, and then equals 860. Each constraint has to have its own slack variable. You can't use the same s for both. Now the next constraints that you see are all the ones about greater than or equal to 0. We have x1 is greater than or equal to 0, x2 is greater than or equal to 0, x3 is greater than or equal to 0, x4 is greater than or equal to 0. These do not need to go into the matrix, so I can just forget about those at this point. The object function z equals 8x1 plus 5x2 plus 3x3 plus 2x4 does have to go into the matrix. It already is an equation, so it does not need a slack variable, but it needs to be rearranged so that the x1 in my object function lines up with the x1 in the other equations, and similar with the x2, the x3. So right now, the 8x1 in my object function is on the right-hand side of the equals, which is not going to work because every other equation has the x1 on the left side of the equals. So in order to get that 8x1 in my object function over to the left side of the equals so that it can be written first, it can be brought over, but it becomes a negative 8x1. And then the object function next has a 5x2, which I also want to move from the right side of the equals to the left side, and it'll become a negative 5x2. And next piece of my object function is 3x3, which again is going to have to move from the right side of the equal sign to the left and will become a negative 3x3. And the last piece is 2x4. Again, that's 2x4 on the right side of the equal sign of my object function. I want to bring it to the left side of the equal sign, so it'll be a negative 2x4. Now, with the other two equations where I added a slack variable, I don't need to do that for the object function because it already is an equation. So I don't leave anything for s, but I do have to include the z that's part of my object function, and then equals, and now what's on the other side of for my equation form for my object function is 0, because everything that was on the right-hand side was moved to the left-hand side. So what's left behind would be 0. So now, at this point of the problem, I have every constraint and my equation that I need for the matrix written as an equation, and written in a way where the variables line up. So now it can be written as a matrix. So it's best, I think, with a matrix this large to label your column headings. So I'm going to need to have an x1 column an x2 column, an x3 column, an x4 column. There is no x5, so I stop with the x's, but I'm going to have an s1 and s2 column. So there's an s1 column, then an s2 column. Then next I'll have to have a column for z. And now after the equals, I have some numbers, so I would label that column RHS, which stands for right-hand side. RHS is right-hand side. And I'll put a line. You don't really have to, but most books do. And now the top equation that I wrote before becomes the top line of the matrix. So the top equation was 2x1 plus 3x2 plus 5x3 plus x4 plus s1 equals 1200. So it goes in as the top line of my matrix, except without the variables. So the 2x1 just puts a 2 in the x1 column, the 3x2 puts a 3 in the x2 column, the 5x3 puts a 5 in the x3 column, the 1x4 will just put a 1 in the x4 column, the 1s1 puts a 1 in the s1 column. The next column is S2. The top equation has no S2, so I put a 0 on the top row of my matrix. Same situation for the Z. I have a Z column next. There is no Z in the top equation, so the Z column of my matrix gets a 0. And the RHS column for right-hand side gets a 1,200. So the next equation I want to put into my matrix is 3x1 plus 2x2 plus 6x3 plus x4 plus s2 equals 860. So again, essentially that's going to become the second row of my matrix, except without the variables. So the 3x1 just goes in as a 3 in the x1 column. The 2x2 goes in as a 2 in the x2 column. The 6x3 goes in as a 6 in the x3 column. The 1x4 goes in as a 1 in the x4 column. The next column is s1, and the second equation has no s1, so I put a 0 in the second row of the matrix. The equation has a 1s2, so I do put in a 1 in the s2 column. The second equation has no z, so I put a 0 in the z column. And the right-hand side value for my second equation is 860. So, one more equation, one more row of my matrix. The third equation is negative 8x1 minus 5x2 minus 3x3 minus 2x4 plus z equals 0. So again, I'm just going to write those same values without the variables. The negative 8x1 puts in a negative 8 in the x1 column. The negative 5x2 puts in a negative 5 in the x2 column. The negative 3x3 puts in a negative 3 in the x3 column. The negative 2x4 puts in a negative 2 in the x4 column. Again, don't forget the negatives. That's important. Then the next two columns are for s, for the slack variables. The bottom equation had no slack variables because it came from the object function. So s1 and s2 both take a 0 on the bottom row of my matrix. There is a z, so in the z column for the bottom row I put in a 1. And the right-hand side value for my bottom row of the matrix is 0 from the bottom equation I had written. And that's the answer for this problem.